Justin, we'll continue with electrolysis. Okay, today we will talk about electrolysis of aqueous solution of copper sulfate, electroplating by silver and electroplating by nickel, and then if time permits we will talk about electro refining as well. Okay, and then end the chapter. So without wasting time, I want to talk about the electrolysis of aqueous solution of copper sulfate. So as you know, the diagram, this is called the voltmeter or the electrolytic cell or the voltmeter, and we have the setup. We have the anode and the cathode, the electrodes. The positive is called the anode and the negative is called the cathode, which is connected. The cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, whereas the anode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, so that hence it is positively charged and this is negatively charged electrode, and they have the respective name. Positive is called the anode and the negative is called the cathode. Okay, and then we have the electrolyte. The electrolyte over here is copper sulfate, CuSO4. And please, before I continue with electrolysis of copper sulfate, let us understand that the color of copper sulfate, CuSO4, is blue. So let me write it with blue chalk. The copper sulfate, CuSO4. Now, it dissociates. Copper sulfate dissociates into, since copper sulfate is soluble in water, copper sulfate dissociates into Cu2+ and SO4 2-. Okay, now since we have water in the aqueous solution of copper sulfate, so water also dissociates into ions H+ and OH- ions. So the question might be name the ions present in the electrolyte of copper using copper sulfate. Then there are copper ions, positive anions are sulfate ions and hydroxyl ions, and positive ions or cations are copper ions and hydrogen ions. Okay, now what happens is it dissociates. These ions are present in the electrolyte. All right, these ions, copper ions, sulfate ions, hydrogen ions and hydroxyl ions, are present in the electrolyte. The electrolyte is actually copper sulfate plus aqueous solution of copper sulfate, means water also dissociates. So we have four ions, copper ions, hydrogen ions, they are the cations, and the anions are sulfate ions and hydroxyl ions. There are there millions of it in the electrolyte. Now, as the electricity passes through it, now what happens is reactions takes place at the cathode and the anode. They get dissociated. Now, reaction at the cathode. Reaction at the cathode. Okay, remember what happens. Reaction at the cathode. Which ions are attracted to the cathode? The positive ions or the cations are attracted towards the cathode. So both copper ions and hydrogen ions, both of them migrate towards copper ions, Cu2+, and H+ ions. Both of them, both these ions, all the positive ions migrate towards the cathode, attracted towards the cathode. Okay, now what will happen? Both of them gets attracted to the cathode, but copper will get discharged. Why? Because of the electrochemical series. So page number 110, if you have a look, if you can refer to page number 110 right now, and then look at the electrochemical series, you will see that copper is lower than hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So those elements or those radicals or those cations and anions which are lower than the, since we are talking here about the cations, so those cations which below hydrogen will get, or lower in the electrochemical series for that matter, will get dissociated. Though those cations below the electrochemical. The lowest in the electrochemical series will get dissociated. So hydrogen is below hydrogen, we have copper ions. So copper will get dissociated according to the electrochemical series. So both of them gets attracted towards the cathode, but nothing happens to hydrogen. Hydrogen do not get dissociated, it remains in the solution. But copper, now what happens to copper? These copper ions which are there in the electrolyte, Cu2 plus ions, now will receive, it will give, cathode will give two electrons to the copper ions. So copper ions will receive two electrons from the cathode and discharged as copper atoms, and the copper atoms will stick to the cathode. Is it okay? So what is the product? It is the copper metal is the product at the cathode. Now the reaction at the anode. Now reaction of the anode depends upon which anode we are using or the electrode we are using. Okay, now over here we are using copper electrodes and copper anode. Okay, if we are using copper anode, then what will happen? Now remember that copper, silver, nickel, these are active, gold, these are active electrode. Active electrode means they take part in the electrochemical reaction. Okay, so copper is an active electrode. Let me tell you again, copper, silver, nickel, gold, these are not the only ones, but some of them, these are active electrodes. Okay, so since copper is an active electrode, it takes part in the chemical reaction. Okay, so since it takes part in the chemical reaction, well, how does it take part in the chemical reaction? I'll tell you. Now actually, okay, what will happen over here is, I don't want to complicate things, just remember that since copper is an active electrode, what happens? The reaction just opposite to this. Remember, the reaction is just opposite to the reaction at the cathode. How? Now, this copper anode will produce copper ions, Cu2 plus ions in the solution. Are you getting my point? So copper ions will be produced in the solution, and this will keep two electrons from the copper atom. From this electrode, copper atom of this electrode, two electrons are kept, and it releases copper ions, Cu2 plus. So just the opposite of this, Cu minus two electrons will produce copper ions, Cu2 plus. So instead of this reaction, you can write it like this. Cu produces Cu2 plus two electrons. Also, you can write it. So whichever you find it easy in understanding, so please write it that Cu minus two electrons. I'm talking about the copper anode here. Okay, so copper will produce copper ions and keeps the two electrons, and these electrons will come here and will be given to copper ions. Of the same copper ions, it will receive two electrons, becomes copper atom, and stick to it. Are you getting my point? So Cu minus two electrons will give you Cu ion. So what are the products? What is the product at the anode? There is no product. So nothing is discharged at the anode. So actually copper ions are produced. Okay. So both the sulfate ions and hydroxyl ions go to the anode, but none of them will get discharged. Why? Because copper is an active electrode, and instead of discharging sulfate ions over here or hydroxyl ions, depending upon the electrochemical series, both of them do not, none of them will get discharged. So sulfate ions and hydroxyl ions remain in the solution. It will not be discharged. Instead, it produces, since copper is an active electrode, it produces copper ions. Okay? Copper ions are produced. Now, if platinum electrode is used, suppose if instead of copper, platinum electrode is used. Platinum electrode is used. Now, what happens? Okay, because a platinum, as you all know, it is an inert electrode, does not take part in the electrochemical reaction. So what will happen? Now, when we use platinum electrode, platinum, if we have platinum and anode, then the reaction at the cathode will be the same. Copper ions will go to the cathode, and cathode will give two electrons, and it will be discharged as copper atoms. So copper metal is deposited at the cathode. That is simple. Now, what happens at the anode now? Because now we are previously in the earlier we had copper electrodes. So copper electrode is active, but over here now we have platinum electrode, which is inert. Now, what will happen to the both of them will be attracted towards the sulfate ions, and the hydroxyl ions are attracted towards the sulfate ions, and hydroxyl ions are attracted towards the anode. Now, what will happen is the OH ions will get discharged, because OH is below the sulfate. Below sulfate, if you compare in the electrochemical series, SO42 minus and OH minus, OH is below electrochemical series compared to sulfate, so OH will get discharged like water. Okay, now what happens is OH minus ions reaction at the anode. OH minus ions will lose one electron and becomes OH. And since OH is very, very unstable, OH is very, very unstable, so 2OH will produce oxygen and water. Produces oxygen and water. Okay? So, sorry, not 2OH, 4OH. So, OH will combine together and forms water and oxygen. So, oxygen is the product at the anode. Why? Because water will go back to the electrolyte. Okay, water will go back to the electrolyte. So, what is the product? Oxygen is the product. Now, another thing that you have to remember is, if you use the copper electrode, every time electrolysis takes place, copper ions are discharged at the anode. So this will produce copper ions to the electrolyte, and it keeps two electrons. These two electrons will go and goes to the cathode, and then again these two electrons will be discharged. The electrons kept here will be discharged here. Okay, and this copper ions will come here, will go to the cathode and receive two electrons, and copper is deposited here. So that is the process here. So what happens is, every time electrolysis is taking place, copper ions are being produced in the solution, isn't it? So if the copper anode is used, for every copper ions that are discharged at the cathode, as a neutral copper atom, copper ions will be added to the solution from the anode. So, and from the anode, copper ions are added to the solution. So, the concentration of copper ions will remain the same. So the blue color of the solution will remain as it is, because the blue color in the solution is because of the copper ions. So every time electrolysis takes place, copper ions are discharged at the will be produced in the released in the electrolyte. So the concentration of copper ions will remain the same. So it will remain, the color of the solution will remain intact, it will remain blue. But in the case of if platinum electrode is used, then what happens? Copper, because platinum is an inert electrode, platinum cannot replace copper ions. So therefore, every time the electrolysis takes place, copper ions are being discharged at the cathode and there is no replacement at the cathode. So therefore, the concentration of copper ions becomes lesser and lesser, as well as the color of the solution, the blue solution, also becomes dimmer and dimmer. It will fade away. All right. So I hope you understood the electrolysis of copper sulfate solution using copper electrode as well as platinum electrode. Now we carry on with the applications of electrolysis. So what are the applications of electrolysis? Number one, is electroplating. We call it electroplating. Now, what is electroplating? Actually, electroplating is, why is it done? To make articles attractive. Like suppose you have an article made up of brass or maybe iron, and you want to make it very, very attractive. So what do? We put a thin layer of another attractive metal like silver, gold, chromium, or nickel, and make it very, very attractive. How is it done? Chemically. It is done chemically, putting a layer of coating of superior metal on a baser metal to make the article attractive. That is called electrolysis, electroplating. So electroplating is the electrolytic process of deposition of superior metal on a baser metal, on the surface of the baser metal, to make it actually attractive, or to make it less corrosive, okay, to protect it from corrosion. So that is electroplating. These are the uses of electroplating. So number one, it makes it attractive, and the other is it prevents corrosion of the baser metal. Okay, now another simple things that you have to understand during electroplating is, number one, this is the diagram of electroplating with nickel. I'll tell you. Number one, the things that you have to remember. Number one, what is it? The article to be electroplated. Suppose you have a ring. Suppose you have a brass ring or an iron ring or a copper ring. You want to electroplate it with, let's say, silver. Okay, so now the whatever article you have to want to electroplate, maybe it could be a spoon or it could be a knife, whatever. Any article, if you want to electroplate it, you keep it as a cathode. So cathode would be, cathode is made up of the article which has to be electroplated, and the anode will be the article, will be the metal with which you want to electroplate this article with. Suppose if you want to electroplate it with nickel, you use a pure nickel block as an anode. If you want to electroplate it with gold, the anode will be made up of pure gold. Or if you want to electroplate it with silver, the anode will be silver block. And the article with which you want, the article you want to electroplate will be your cathode. Please remember that. Now the In the electrolyte, you must have the ions of the metal with which you want to electroplate. That means if you want to electroplate it with nickel, you must have a nickel salt. If you are electroplating with gold, you must have a gold salt as an electrolyte. If you are electroplating with silver, you will use a silver salt. Okay, and then last thing you have to remember is low current is used. Low current is used. Why? Because if you use a higher current, the rate of deposition will be very, very fast, and the deposition will not be smooth. So slow and steady wins the race, as we call it. So we will use a very low current, that the electrolytic process is very slow, so that it will have even deposition in the article. Is it okay? So these are some of the conditions that you have to remember before we start, before we understand electroplating. Now we first do, we'll consider electroplating an article with nickel. We electroplate it with nickel, okay? So we electroplate it with nickel, Ni. I'll write it with blue. Nickel, Ni. Okay. Now, electroplating with nickel. Now, what is the electrolyte used? You have to remember the electrolyte. These are the things you have to remember during electroplating. Electrolyte is aqueous solution of nickel sulfate. NiSO4. Aq means aqueous solution of nickel sulfate. What is the anode? Anode used is nickel block. And what is the cathode? Cathode used will be the article. Article to be electroplated. Let's say in this case it's a spoon. Okay. These are the things you have to remember. How much current is used? Very low current is used for a long period of time, so that we'll have even deposition of nickel metal in the article. Now, what is the reaction that takes place during electroplating? Please remember them. Reaction at the cathode. No, before that, I want to tell you what ions are present in the electrolyte. Ions present. Yeah. Okay, ions present. Ions present is nickel sulfate, NiSO4. Gets dissociated into Ni2+ and SO4 2 minus. And of course, since we have aqueous solution, we will have water as well. So water will dissociate into, as we all know, H+ and OH minus ions. So the ions present in the electrolyte, you must understand that nickel sulfate dissociates into Ni2+ and SO4 2 minus, and water ionizes into H+ and OH minus ions. So ions present, positive ions present are nickel and hydrogen. Negative ions or the anions present are sulfate and OH minus ions. All right. So now reaction at the cathode. So if you have a look, that nickel again in the electrochemical series, nickel is lower than hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So if we compare nickel and hydrogen, both of them go to the cathode. The nickel ions Ni2+ and H+. Both of them are attracted towards the cathode because they are positively charged. Okay, opposite charges they attract. So nickel ions and hydrogen ions, both positive ions, are cations, are attracted towards the cathode. But who will get discharged? Who will get discharged? Nickel among the two, because nickel is lower in the electrochemical series. So what will happen is Ni2+ it will receive two electrons. So cathode will give two electrons to the nickel at ion and becomes Ni, and the nickel ions will be deposited all over the article, that is the spoon in this case. Understood? Now the reaction at the anode. The reaction at the anode will be, now what happens to the reaction? Now, as I told you, nickel, silver, gold, chromium, these are active electrode. Okay, it is an active electrode. So the anode, the nickel anode, will produce nickel ions Ni2+. So the nickel ions the nickel block will Ni2+ Ni minus 2 electrons will produce nickel ions Ni 2 plus. Is it okay? Just the opposite of this, I told you. If it's an active electrode, just the opposite of Ni minus 2 electrons produces nickel ions Ni 2 plus. Is it okay? So this is producing two ions. It will keep from the atom of nickel, from the nickel block, it will keep two electrons. These two electrons will travel to the cathode and the two electrons will be given to the nickel, again the same nickel ions which comes to the, goes to the cathode, and it will be, it will stick to it. So this is how actually the electroplating of nickel is done on an article using the electrolyte nickel sulfate. Now we go to electroplating with silver now. Electroplating with silver. Okay, the same process, somewhat the same, but the electrolyte will be obviously be different. The electrolyte will obviously be different. So in this case, if you have to electroplate it with silver now, we use a silver block, pure silver block. We use Ag block, silver block, Ag, silver, okay, as the anode. And of course, the cathode will be the article to be electroplated, and a low current is used. Why low current again? Because it'll ensure that we'll have a slow and smooth deposition on the cathode. So, silver, electroplating with silver. So what is the electrolyte? Sodium argentocyanide. It is sodium argentocyanide. Na, Ag, Cn, twice. This is the electrolyte. Na, Ag, Cn, twice is the electrolyte. Sodium silver cyanide or sodium argento cyanide, we call it. And what is the anode? The anode will be silver block. Silver block. And what is the cathode? Again, the article to be electroplated. The article to be electroplated is the cathode and the metal with which you want to electroplate. In this case, silver. So the anode, we make it a silver block. Now, what are the ions present now? You got to remember. So, Na, Ag, Cn, twice. This is sodium argento. It's a complex salt. Na, Ag, Cn, twice. It dissociates into sodium ions and silver ions and cyanide ions. 2Cn minus. Okay. Now, of course, since it is aqueous solution of NaAgCn twice, so we have water as well. So water dissociates into, ionizes, sorry, into H plus and OH minus ions, as we all know. Now the reaction, what are the ions present? Sodium ions, silver ions and hydrogen ions among the cations. And as far as negative ions or the cations, anions are concerned, it is cyanide ions and hydroxyl ions present in the electrolyte. Present in the electrolyte. So electrolyte is Ag, Na, Ag, Cn twice is the electrolyte. So among them, all the positive ions will be attracted towards the cathode. Silver ions, sodium ions as well as hydrogen ions are attracted towards the cathode. But which ion will get dissociated? It is the silver ions will get dissociated. Why? Because silver in the electrochemical cell is in the lowest form, so place. So the one which is at the lowest is will get discharged. So silver ions will go to, obviously will be attracted towards the, and all of them, but silver will get discharged. So it will give one electron. The cathode will give, Ag plus will receive one electron from the cathode and becomes silver and stick to it. Stick to the surface of the spoon or the article or the cathode here. Now, what is the reaction at the anode? Because anode, silver, is made up of silver block. It's an active electrode, so it will discharge silver ions, Ag+. So just the reaction over here is just the opposite to the reaction on the top. So Ag minus one electron will produce silver ions at the anode. So that electron which has one electron is kept, and that electron will go to the cathode, and again it is produced to neutralize the silver ion, and the silver ion will get silver atoms will get stuck to the cathode. So this is all about electroplating, or by silver and by nickel. So electrorefining. Now let me tell you a little bit about electrorefining. We can refer to page number 120. I'm sure you will understand. So electroplating is a process by which metals containing impurities will be purified electrolytically to a given pure metal. So this is also an application. Electrorefining and electroplating are the two applications of electroplating, electrorefining and electroplating. So electrorefining is almost the same as electrolysis of copper sulfate using copper electrode. It is exactly the same. The only difference is the electrodes. In electrorefining, the anode is made up of impure block of copper, the metal which you want to purify, okay? And the cathode is made up of thin strip of, suppose if you are refining copper, okay? If you are refining copper, then anode is made up of impure block of copper, and the cathode is made up of thin strip of pure block of copper, and the rest is the same as the reaction or the electrolysis of aqueous copper sulfate using copper electrode. Okay, so I'm sure you have understood. So we have completed the chapter called electrolysis. So we will go on with maybe metallurgy, or let's talk about organic chemistry. Depends. So we might do metallurgy or organic chemistry in the next class after Puja vacation. So happy Dashara to all. May you